Why digital? This is a question I hear often, and I'm going to share with you today my very unique perspective. I'm going to start with a quote from Malcolm Gladwell. "We have come to confuse information with understanding." And I think this is something that we commonly feel at this organization today and throughout the world. We're great at information gathering. We're gathering a ton of information and putting it in our electronic health record, but we aren't really sure yet how this is enhancing our understanding of the patients, not to mention our outcomes. So let's review. What is the purpose of a health record? And I'm going to say that the purpose of a health record is so that we can capture an understanding of our patient, so that we can share that understanding of our patient with each other, other members of the care team, with the patients, and with their families, so that we can keep track of how our patient and our understanding of our patient changes over time. So I'm clearly trying to emphasize a point here, and that is our health record should be about understanding. So let's talk a little bit about the architecture of information versus the architecture of understanding. As an informaticist, it's my job to think about information and how information comes into a system and where it flows and how it's presented within the system. So I spend a lot of time talking and thinking about the architecture of information. And I'm going to challenge myself and you all to have a little change of thought, and instead of thinking architecture of information, to think architecture of understanding. So as I said, it's a common situation that we gather as much information as we possibly can because we think that that is going to lead to better care. But as a result, we end up drowning in information and we're missing the song for the static. And so this is often how it feels. In your thirst for knowledge, be sure not to drown in all of the information. So what's ideal information? My vision for the future is that we record and display information that actually helps to enhance our understanding of our patients. And we can look at information as tiles in a mosaic of understanding. So this is all pretty abstract, and actually I'm going to get even more abstract on you for a few seconds in order to explain a little bit better what understanding and the architecture of understanding is. And we're going to use a pathway to self-knowledge as a model. So, imagine this purple box on the screen is your self-knowledge. The top part of this box is the information that you know about yourself. The left-hand side of this box is information that other people know about you. So that means that the top left-hand corner is what you know about yourself and others know about you. So this is common information. The right-hand box is what you know about yourself but other people don't, so that's kind of your dirty little secrets that you don't really want to share. The bottom left-hand corner is what other people know about you that you don't, and that's a little scary. And then the bottom right-hand corner is what nobody knows. It's what you don't know and what others don't know, but it's still part of who you are. So how do we learn more about ourselves? There's two forces that we have to use. We have to use transparency. So we reveal to others what we know about ourselves, which pushes this line over. And we have to use the force of reflection. We have to reflect with others about their view of us and then learn from them. And through these two forces, through transparency and reflection, we move the lines over. And this little box here that nobody knows becomes smaller and smaller. So the interesting thing about this is that relationship is key to understanding. It's through relationships with others that we can increase the understanding of ourselves through transparency and reflection. So how does this apply to healthcare? In my view, the health record needs to be transparent to the health team. It needs to be legible. It needs to be available. It needs to be easy to view. It needs to focus on information that improves our understanding. And the information in the record needs to be reflected upon. That means that we should be validating that information with the patient to make sure that we are accurately representing them. It needs to display an open discussion amongst providers, especially if there is a difference of opinion. And it needs to be communicated to the patient and approved outside providers. Our idea is to make the health record one source of truth. This is shared information. The summary screen then becomes foundational. It's all inclusive, and that means as long as we have little bits and pieces of paper that aren't included in the health record floating around the organization, we're missing tiles to our mosaic, and we will not have a full understanding of who our patient is. So we do need to get all of our pieces of paper into the computer. We need to make sure that the thoughts are traceable to the owner and the thoughts are traceable to actions. We also need to make sure that actions are traceable to results. So I'm going to draw a roadmap for you. Let's put the patient at the center. And here are all the things that are important to the patient. We have the patient's story. We have data that we're gathering on the patient. We have clinicians' thoughts, patients' wishes, family's input. We have the actions that are taken, and we have response to those actions. So now let's look at the bits of the electronic health record that address each of these areas. The history is captured in our clinical documentation, and eventually it will be captured in our patient portal as well when we start allowing patients to actually enter things into their own chart. Data is already captured through lab radiology, micro, and nursing assessments. The clinician's thoughts are being captured through clinical documentation. Patient's wishes will be captured through the patient portal and advanced directives. Family's input will also be captured through patient portal and documented family meetings. Actions is a bit of a big one here. We have multiple projects that have to occur to keep track of our actions. We have CPOE, we have BMV-EMAR, and nursing interventions. And then responses to those actions are captured in clinical documentation, data, and graphs. So what is digital? Let's redefine digital. Digital to us should be transparent, reflective, available, and accurate. So in the end, digital is what we make of it. So let's make it patient-centered and let's build it with our core values. That's compassion, professionalism, and respect. We should remember that the best way to care for our patients is to really care for our patients. We should understand that it's our duty to seek to understand the truth and to reflect that truth in our electronic health record. And we should always remember that our patients are very vulnerable and we are being entrusted with their vulnerability, so we should be respecting that.